Going back to school online. Going back to school online is the process of pursuing or completing a degree or certificate program through an online platform, rather than attending classes in person. Some possible ways to monetize going back to school online are: improving your career prospects. Going back to school online can help you advance in your current career or switch to a new one by acquiring new skills, credentials, or qualifications. You can potentially earn a higher income or access more opportunities in your field of interest. Saving money on tuition and expenses. Going back to school online can be more affordable than attending a traditional campus, as you can save on costs such as transportation, housing, food, or childcare. You can also choose from a variety of online programs that fit your budget and schedule. Creating your own educational products. Going back to school online can inspire you to create your own educational products, such as courses, books, podcasts, or blogs, that share your knowledge and expertise with others. You can charge for access, usage, or features of your products. Offering tutoring or mentoring services. Going back to school online can enable you to offer tutoring or mentoring services to other students who need academic support or guidance. You can charge by the hour or by the session. Applying for scholarships or grants. Going back to school online can make you eligible for various scholarships or grants that can help you fund your education or research. You can apply for financial aid from various sources, such as schools, organizations, or governments. Online meetings. Online meetings are virtual gatherings of people who communicate and collaborate using web-based tools, such as video conferencing, chat, or screen sharing too. Some possible ways to monetize online meetings are: selling meeting software or hardware. You can create and sell meeting software or hardware that facilitate online meetings, such as webcams, microphones, speakers, or apps. You can charge by the product or by the feature. Offering meeting facilitation services. You can use online meetings to provide meeting facilitation services, such as planning, hosting, moderating, or recording meetings for clients who need it for personal or business use. You can charge by the service or by the result. Creating meeting content. You can use online meetings to create and share meeting content, such as presentations, reports, surveys, or polls, that enhance the quality and effectiveness of meetings. You can charge by the content or by the access. Running meeting ads. You can use online meetings to run text or image ads on your meeting screens or windows. You can earn revenue from advertisers who want to reach your audience. Teaching meeting skills. You can use online meetings to teach meeting skills to students online. You can charge by the lesson or by the course. Parties and online celebrations. Parties and online celebrations are social events that involve fun activities and interactions among people who join using web-based tools, such as video conferencing, chat, or games 3. Some possible ways to monetize parties and online celebrations are: selling party supplies or services. You can create and sell party supplies or services that enhance parties and online celebrations, such as decorations, costumes, food delivery, music streaming, or photography. You can charge by the item or by the package. Offering party planning services. You can use parties and online celebrations to provide party planning services, such as designing themes, invitations, agendas, games, or prizes for clients who need it for personal or business use. You can charge by the service or by the result. Creating party content. You can use parties and online celebrations to create and share party content, such as videos, photos, stories, or memes that capture the fun and memorable moments of parties and online celebrations. You can charge by the content or by the access. Running party ads. You can use parties and online celebrations to run text or image ads on your party screens or windows. You can earn revenue from advertisers who want to reach your audience. Teaching party skills. You can use parties and online celebrations to teach party skills to students online. You can charge by the lesson or by the course. Selling digital products. Selling digital products is the process of creating and selling products that exist in digital form only, such as ebooks, courses, software, or music. Some possible ways to monetize selling digital products are: creating your own digital products. You can create your own digital products that showcase your knowledge, skills, or creativity, and sell them to customers who are interested in your niche or topic. You can charge by the product or by the feature. Offering digital product creation services. You can use your expertise and tools to provide digital product creation services, such as writing, editing, designing, or marketing digital products for clients who need it for personal or business use. You can charge by the service or by the result. Creating a digital product marketplace. You can create a digital product marketplace that connects digital product creators and customers, and earn a commission from each sale or transaction. You can charge by the sale or by the access. Running digital product ads. You can use your digital products or platforms to run text or image ads on your digital product pages or windows. You can earn revenue from advertisers who want to reach your audience. Teaching digital product skills. You can use your digital products or platforms to teach digital product skills to students online. You can charge by the lesson or by the course. Cryptocurrency. Cryptocurrency is a form of digital money that is secured by cryptography and operates on a decentralized network of computers, such as blockchain 1. Some possible ways to monetize cryptocurrency are buying and holding cryptocurrency. You can buy and hold cryptocurrency as a long-term investment, hoping that its value will increase over time. You can sell your cryptocurrency when you want to cash out or exchange it for another currency. Trading cryptocurrency. You can trade cryptocurrency as a short-term investment, buying and selling it frequently to take advantage of price fluctuations. You can use various strategies and tools, such as technical analysis, indicators, or bots, to help you make profitable trades. Mining cryptocurrency. You can mine cryptocurrency by using your computer's processing power to solve complex mathematical problems and verify transactions on the network. You can earn rewards in the form of new coins or transaction fees. Staking cryptocurrency. You can stake cryptocurrency by locking up your coins in a wallet or a platform that supports staking. You can earn rewards in the form of interest or dividends for helping to secure the network or provide liquidity. Creating your own cryptocurrency. You can create your own cryptocurrency by using existing platforms or protocols, such as Ethereum or Binance Smart Chain, or by developing your own code. You can launch your cryptocurrency through an initial coin offering, ICO, or an initial exchange offering, IEO, and sell it to investors or users. Stocks. Stocks are shares of ownership in a company that are traded on a stock market too. Some possible ways to monetize stocks are buying and holding stocks. You can buy and hold stocks as a long-term investment, hoping that the company's performance and value will increase over time. You can sell your stocks when you want to cash out or diversify your portfolio. Trading stocks. You can trade stocks as a short-term investment, buying and selling them frequently to take advantage of price fluctuations. You can use various strategies and tools, such as fundamental analysis, news, or signals, to help you make profitable trades. Dividend investing. You can invest in stocks that pay regular dividends, which are distributions of a company's earnings to its shareholders. You can reinvest your dividends to buy more shares or use them as a source of passive income. Growth investing. You can invest in stocks that have high growth potential, which are usually companies that are innovative, disruptive, or expanding rapidly. You can expect higher returns from these stocks, but also higher risks. Value investing. You can invest in stocks that are undervalued by the market, which are usually companies that are stable, profitable, or have strong fundamentals. You can expect lower returns from these stocks, but also lower risks. Real estate. Real estate is property that consists of land and the buildings on it, as well as the natural resources of the land. Some possible ways to monetize real estate are buying and holding real estate. You can buy and hold real estate as a long-term investment, hoping that its value will appreciate over time. You can sell your real estate when you want to cash out or exchange it for another property. Flipping real estate. You can flip real estate as a short-term investment, buying and selling it quickly to take advantage of price differences. You can use various strategies and tools, such as market research, renovation, or staging, to help you make profitable flips. Renting out real estate. You can rent out real estate as a source of passive income, collecting rent from tenants who occupy your property. You can use various platforms or services, such as Airbnb or Zillow, to help you find and manage tenants. Investing in real estate companies. You can invest in real estate companies that own, operate, develop, or manage properties or related services. You can buy shares of these companies on the stock market or invest in funds that focus on real estate sectors. Investing in real estate tokens. You can invest in real estate tokens that represent fractional ownership of properties or projects that are tokenized on a blockchain platform. You can buy and sell these tokens on crypto exchanges or platforms that support real estate tokenization.